A few days ago, a small group of Model A'ers received an invitation to view Doug Clayton's private collection of Ford Model A's. I asked if I could video the cars and share with you on the YouTube channel. Doug was very gracious and agreed. So Doug is the past president of the Model A Ford Club of America. I met Doug several years ago when doing my first Model A fine point restoration. He was really helpful in getting the originality I was looking for. So I had the privilege of judging alongside Doug at the NCRG Roundup in Sonoma, and his knowledge of the Model A is unmatched. I've seen a few of Doug's Model A's and judged one at the NCRG Roundup in Modesto, so I knew this was going to be epic. So we joined the rest of the selected few invitees and Model A's and traveled to the super secret undisclosed location. Upon arriving, we were met outside by Doug's lovely wife, Debbie, and we were escorted inside. The first impressions once inside? Stunning. The first Model A to catch my eye was an early 1928 Phaeton, actually built in 1927. Serial number 495. This Model A was shown at the 2014 Model A Ford Club of America meet in French Lick and scored 495 out of 500 points in the prestigious Blue Ribbon class. Just across the warehouse was a car that drew me to it. Although I had seen this car before at the NCRG Roundup in Sonoma, I was immediately drawn to it again. It's one of only two Model A town car prototypes built in April 1928. Henry Ford gave this car to Eleanor Whiting as a gift originally, and it was tan. It has some amazing one-of-a-kind features and parts. The other one was destroyed in a fire in 1962. This is the only one remaining. Right next to the town car is another very rare Model A, a 1931 town car delivery, Model 295A. Only 191 were built in 1931, and only 7 are known to exist today. The town car delivery was a really upscale way to deliver things like jewelry or flowers. It has some unusual lights on the sides designed to light up the company logos painted on it. Doug gave me a really personal tour around the town car delivery, and being the master judge and perfectionist he is, pointed out a few of the discrepancies.
The door was probably ochre ash. Now they've stained it in the alder color, and you know when this car was built, this would have been spray painted with everything else, and then the paneling screwed on. So that right there is a deduction. I know, I'm picky, okay? But, I mean, look how beautiful it is. The chrome-plated finishes and all. That's the canopy top. This is extra top material that I bought from Tim for the other town cars. And if you look at the material on the front seat, this is similar, but it's genuine leather. And it's perfect compared to the original, as that is the original material on that town car. So anyway, even though it's a beautiful restoration, it still would lose a point here and there.
As I said earlier, there's only 7 town car deliveries from 1931 known to still exist. Doug has 2 of them. This one was acquired from Tim Kelly's estate a few years ago, sporting the original General Electric logos believed to have been on there when bought by its first owner. Just over the hood of the 295A is another very rare Model A commercial vehicle. This is a deluxe pickup, Model 66A. On May 1, 1931, Ford released the 66A as a promotional vehicle for use by General Electric. It was based on the 229A service car, and unlike the other Ford Model A pickups, the 66A has a polished stainless radiator shell, headlights, and cowl band. The deluxe pickup is very distinctive with its wide bed and sides connected directly to the cab and unique chrome-plated side rails. The tailgate and hardware is unique to this model. It's believed there are only 17 deluxe pickups left in the world. Those who know me know that I love unrestored Model A's, and Doug has several unrestored Model A's in his collection. Here's an early 1930 four-door sedan right next to a mid-1930 four-door sedan. And seeing these two original unrestored cars next to each other was breathtaking. The originality of these two is unmistakable, and aside from some gentle use over the years and lack of cleaning or polishing, these two Model A's draw your attention right away. In the back corner were two more unrestored Model A's that just look like they're begging for restoration after some pretty hard use. The 1929 Sport Coupe retains its original top material and even some of its paint. Right next to the Sport Coupe is this 1931 Ford Special Delivery. This commercial model 255A isn't exactly rare, but it isn't abundant either. A lot of these suffer from rot, but not this one. Still running and driving well, this delivery was just asking to tour home with us. There were a lot more Model A's to check out, but time was wasting and the outside temperatures were soaring, so we had to drive our mundane two-door sedan back home. Now's the time to click the subscribe button, and thank you so much for watching.